cabinet meeting on March 24th, I asked Councillor Simon Carter, where is the condition survey for the roof, for the windows, and for the cladding, as we had not received it yet. I was informed verbally that we would receive it. Your written response made no reference to it. To date, we have still not had a condition survey for the cladding or the roofs, and have now been informed that only the flat roofs were surveyed. There have been no surveys for any of the pitched roofs on 5 acres. No response regarding the cladding, which I find unacceptable. As in our block, we've already had cladding replacement, which I have paid for. I have the invoice and the receipt. I suggest that block 7 to 17, which is timber clad, is in need of repair. Apparently, our windows will now be individually surveyed by the contractor. Thank you. My question is, if the roofs have not been surveyed, how do you know that they need replacement? One cannot make an assumption that this is a requirement. Repairs may be sufficient, and there are older properties in Harlow that have not been forced to have such works.
Thank you, Joe, and thank you for your question. Clearly understand your concerns and uncertainty, and we continue to welcome your questions. There is a statutory process we have followed for these works, and following the question that the previous committee, we undertook an extensive review of the process to make sure we were following it correctly. And I continue to commit to providing you with the relevant information to understand the works to be undertaken to the box when it becomes available. Through the normal consultation processes, I understand you have been provided with a notice of intention for the works dated in the 9th of July 2021, a notice of estimate dated the 20th of January 2022, a copy of the intended work specification sent out on the 24th of March 2022, and a breakdown of the works dated the 19th of May. An evening meeting was held on the 20th of June, and a copy of the presentation, question and answers were sent to all the leaseholders on the 8th of July. If you require copies of this information, please don't hesitate to contact the Home Ownership Section. Harlow Council will continue to talk through the leaseholders, the background information to the above, and its intention for further information. We will formulate these together with the conclusions being drawn on the condition of the block and the need for the work being planned as more information becomes available. It is intended for the pitch room to be included in the scope of the process due to a general assessment of their age and ongoing maintenance costs, with the blocks are more than 55 years old. We intend, once the scaffolding is erected, to ensure safe access. Further conditions surveys will be undertaken and an assessment of the next steps. This will be talked through with the leaseholders. The communal windows and condition surveys completed, and surveys of the windows and individual flats are currently being completed. Any windows or roofs that do not require replacement will be omitted from the contract, and this will be discussed with the leaseholders. There's much of interest in planning applications. As landlord, we have a responsibility to ensure the buildings are safe and secure. These works will reduce routine repairs and maintenance and make them more thermally efficient. It will also incorporate the latest fire safety standards, which is a key priority of this administration. Residents will have better quality information and other heating rules. The formal consultation processes and the information provided are aimed to ensure that only works that are appropriate and necessary are carried out.
Do you have any further supplementary questions?
I haven't declared anything in writing.
You don't need to if you have the right to ask a supplementary question, don't you?
Thank you. I speak on behalf of my friends and neighbours. I just feel slightly alarmed that it appears that the decision is already made, a fait accompli, that the roofs are going to be replaced. I can't imagine if you have promised £1 million worth of work as a council to states, the consultants and Cosmere, that they're going to say, oh yeah, that's okay. If you don't want those roofs done, no, that's fine. We'll lose out on hundreds of thousands of pounds worth of work. It doesn't make sense to me.
May I just interrupt a moment?
Sorry.
I understand the emotion that comes from.
Sorry.
If you could come to a question,
I beg your pardon.
The council will answer to the best of his ability. And beyond your question tonight, please feel free to continue to ask questions outside of this forum, or indeed later points when we come back to cabinet, and we can continue to try and answer. If you can bring it to a question, I would appreciate it.
I beg your pardon. I'm just surprised that the council have not conducted a conditioned survey to ascertain what works have to be done. That is what shocks me.
Thank you, Jeff. I don't understand where you're coming from. But unfortunately, you know, we are bound by necessary regulations on how the process has to evolve. As I mentioned in the answer, once we get the scaffolding on site, we can then, or the contractor, and then do a proper site inspection and see what work is actually required and whether it requires replacements or not. Now, when the contractors bid for this work, they do understand what the process is, and at the end of the day, they may not get all of that work. That's how the system works. Not just in Harlow, but across the country. These are national conditions, and that's how the process works. I know it's frustrating that you don't know until the end of the consultation process whether those works are going to be included or not, but it is the process we have to go through. We look at these things, you know, at the start of the process, we go through our own stock condition surveys, which has worked over a number of years, and we estimate from the expected working life of those particular features what needs to be doing in the near future. But you know, as you point out, the full surveys have not been done. It's likely that work may need to be done, but we don't know what condition it actually is. But you know, once we get the scaffolding up and once we get the net out of the ground, we'll then be in a better position to know whether the work needs to be done.
However, I'm sorry. We were told that the council have no records. So how can you look back at your records? I have it in writing when I stated that I'd paid for the cladding.
Ms. Jones, if you have a particular...
Sorry, I would like to know where the records are.
Then I would suggest...